Hello and welcome. My name is Luke Smith. I'm one of the product managers for the KrosFlo TFF systems here at Repligen. And today I'm excited to walk you through a new innovative bench scale TFF solution. When you think about conventional benchtop TFF systems, a lot of them don't have the same features and functionality as large industrial grade CGMP units. And that's because of the purpose for which they were designed. Most bench-scale TFF systems were designed for research, testing, and process development. They were meant for the initial setup, for trials, for identifying and understanding processes, for producing a product, but rarely ever used for or intended for manufacturing that end product. Now, as the industry continues shifting towards personalized medicine and manufacturing therapeutics in really small batches, batch sizes that are synonymous with bench-scale, batches that are very expensive, there's the need to rethink our entire approach to bench-scale TFF systems in applications involving new modalities. And that's why we've developed something new. Today, I'm happy to speak to you about our latest innovation, the new KrosFlo RS10 TFF system. This is the first bench-scale TFF system built specifically for CGMP production with true end-to-end automation. This unit takes all of the components, controls, and capabilities of a highly compliant large-scale TFF system used in commercial manufacturing and brings it down to bench scale. Now, I know I've made some pretty big claims, so let's take a look at what makes it different from every other bench-scale TFF system on the market. Let's start by breaking down the features of conventional bench-scale TFF systems as seen in the process flow diagram on the left. The system uses a feed pump to draw product from a vessel and feed it to the filter membrane. The permeate that passes through the membrane is collected and weighed in a separate vessel, and the retentate is returned to the original. Other pumps may be included, such as an addition pump to support fed batch or diafiltration operations, where additional product or buffer is drawn in to replace the permeate, or a permeate pump for further control of the permeate flow. These systems include pressure sensors on the feed, retentate, and permeate lines to monitor the transmembrane pressure, or driving force across the membrane, as well as a pressure control valve on the retentate line to adjust that pressure. Some of these traditional bench-scale systems, like those offered by Repligen, include an automated pressure control valve, which works in tandem with the feed and permeate pumps to automatically hit or maintain transmembrane pressure and flow rate targets. However, TFF processing by nature requires more steps than just concentration and diafiltration. The majority of the time, there are preparation steps, like flushing the lines with buffer or WIFI, testing the integrity of the flow path and membrane, or testing the permeability of a reused membrane, or sanitization of the product contact surfaces. After concentration and diafiltration, there are also other steps, like product recovery, cleaning, and flushing. On a traditional bench-scale TFF system, all these steps require manual operations and record keeping. The RS10, on the other hand, displayed here on the right, has not only all the needed components to automate concentration and diafiltration, but also all of the inlets, outlets, and valves required to automate all of these pre- and post-operations we've described, and more. This means less hands-on time, less human error, better record keeping and compliance, and overall, improved process efficiency and consistency from batch to batch. Now, since our system contains so many valves throughout the flow path, a necessity for automating TFF processes, as we've seen, let's look at the technologies we employ to optimize the placement and usage of these valves. Similar to our other KrosFlo RS systems, the RS10 utilizes our innovative valve block technology to do two critical things. First, lower total holdup volume, and second, eliminate dead legs. As you can see in this animation on the right-hand side, our valve blocks enable us to cluster a set of automated valves close together. And within the recesses of the system's valve blocks sits our injection molded tubing. This design allows us to keep these compact and minimal, with the intention of reducing extended processing times and concentration target limits caused by extra tubing. But how does this novel approach compare to traditional hose barb assemblies, and how is it superior? If we look at a traditional flow path assembly, as shown on the right, each intersection requires a hose barb fitting. These hard plastic hose barb fittings require that pinch points be located a ways back from the main intersection where the fluid is traveling. This creates a dead leg, as indicated by the orange arrows. These dead legs require more time and fluid in order to completely flush, increasing the risk of material carryover and cross-contamination in between steps. In contrast, our technologies allow us to introduce more valves for enhanced automation, reduced flow path lengths for lower holdup volumes, and mitigate risks by virtually eliminating dead legs. So, we've talked about our automation capabilities and several of the technologies that contribute to a more optimized flow path assembly and fluid dynamics. But what about the type of feed pump used on the system? The fluid dynamics caused by the feed pump have significant impact on your filtration performance and the viability of your product. The majority of bench-scale TFF systems on the market today are based on a peristaltic pump. While simple to use, reliable, and low cost, the higher shear forces produced by this pump type may have a negative impact on more shear-sensitive molecules, such as lentivirus. Considering the wide variety of applications in which these bench systems are used, each with their own unique processing requirements, we see a need to be able to configure this system to best fit your application. To accomplish this, we've also designed the RS10 to be the first TFF system to be offered with your choice of feed pumps, empowering you to tailor the system around your process and not the other way around. So what that means is, if you're really concerned about shear because you're working with highly sensitive molecules like lentivirus, you can order an RS10 with a maglev centrifugal pump for low pressure, low shear applications. If you still value low shear, yet your process demands higher pressures for molecules like mRNA, then you can get an RS10 with a diaphragm pump for high pressure processing that's still gentle on your product. And of course, if your molecules are robust and shear isn't too much of a concern, or you're already platformed on peristaltic pumps and want to keep fluid dynamics the same, the system can also be equipped with a peristaltic pump, which also contributes to some consumable cost savings as you remove the need for a single-use pump head. No other system on the market allows this much flexibility to choose a feed pump to fit your application. But we don't stop with the choice of pump. In keeping with the rest of our TFF systems, the RS10 can also support both hollow fiber filters as well as flat sheet cassettes. Instead of being limited to a system that is only compatible with one membrane format, operators will be able to swap out the holders and plug in a different filter in a matter of minutes. Now, when it comes to installation, our pre-assembled flow paths are very intuitive and devoid of any confusing instructions or complicated assembly. In the case of the RS10, your single-use flow path arrives assembled as a single piece with all the sensors pre-calibrated. Since the tubing is designed to fit within the recesses of the system's valve blocks, there's only one way it can be installed, eliminating much of the guesswork and hassle. Installation is simple and typically done in a matter of minutes. The KrosFlo RS10 also includes advanced analytics and control capabilities. It includes all the sensors we see on traditional bench scale systems, such as feed, retentate, and permeate pressure sensors, and scales for the retentate and permeate vessels, plus a retentate flow sensor and addition line pressure sensor. This enables a number of control methods for the dynamics around the filter. These methods include TMP control and feed flow control, as well as feed, retentate, and permeate, flow, flux, and pressure control, as well as the ability to adapt between control methods automatically as your process progresses. The system also includes an air sensor, so you can automatically switch from fed batch to batch mode when a feed solution has run out. Optionally, the RS10 can also be fitted with pH, conductivity, temperature, and UV sensors. With a point-and-click recipe editor, you can customize your recipes to the nth degree, including have the process adapt automatically based on any of these measured values. Speaking of advanced analytical capabilities, at Repligen, we offer a line of systems called the KrosFlo RPM. Powered by the integration of our FlowVPX inline variable path length spectrophotometer, these systems feature inline protein concentration management, which enables users to control their UFDF process with real-time insights. By leveraging inline concentration data, you can analyze your measurements without doing upfront calculation or overcompensating for variability, providing you with key insights that allow you to better understand your process, reduce cycling time, and batch risk. Rather than relying on mass balance measurements generated from load cells, the system offers live concentration control by taking 12 quality control grade concentration measurements every minute. In some applications, the concentration range can be as wide as 0.1 to 300 milligrams per mil, and does it without requiring offline sampling or dilution. These concentration measurements allow the system software to automatically adjust to the right path length range for accurate measurements. The system is capable of supporting multiple wavelengths with field swappable light sources, including the common 260 and 280 nanometers. For users who favor these features, you can upgrade your RS10 to the RS10 RPM. But what does this mean for your process? Normally, TFF processes use the vessel volume as the driving parameter for when to start, end, or transition between steps. These volumes represent an estimation of the actual concentration. These volume-based estimations can vary significantly from the actual product concentration. Our testing has shown it's not uncommon for these estimates to be off as much as 30% from actual concentration. And taking offline samples to verify concentration, as many of you already know, can be tedious, slow, and negatively impact the viability of your product as it recirculates through the pump, waiting for you to advance to the next step. Having an integrated FlowVPX in the RS10 RPM means this system can automatically react based on live and accurate concentration measurements. This increased accuracy allows you to reduce processing time and unnecessary shear force exposure to your product and enhance reproducibility. In this chart on the right, you can see data from one of our testing runs with an RS system and an integrated FlowVPX. In the chart, you can see the vessel volume in green and the live concentration from the FlowVPX in blue. The system's recipe was written to automatically transition from concentration 1 to diafiltration, then to a final concentration based on the live concentration measurements. In this test, we were able to do more than a 20 times overall concentration and a 6 dV diafiltration while maintaining precise concentration control. With every action automated and an abundance of analytical sensors, the amount of data recorded for every batch on the RS10 is unparalleled for a benchtop system. Having all this data helps you to better fine-tune your processes to be more efficient, improve batch-to-batch consistency, and to troubleshoot issues. Not only does this help your production to be more efficient, but for R&D and PD applications, this can also have a significant impact on speed to market. The system also leverages this data to auto-generate very thorough batch records for enhanced levels of compliance. With a built-in data historian, as well as easy network integration for automatic backups, you know that your data is secure. Integrating the system with some network types can also unlock the ability to operate batches remotely. While other systems at this scale have touchscreens that are so small they are practically unusable, or keyboards that are difficult to use or not really clean room rated, this system features a large touchscreen monitor and full-size glass keyboard. Clean room ready and easy to use. The operator software interface is graphical based on a flow diagram of the system, which makes it intuitive and easy to learn, with everything you need to run the system or start and stop recipes available from a single screen. The software package also includes a dedicated trending software, which allows you to produce fully customizable trends of both live and historical data, as well as a point-and-click recipe editor, which gives you in-depth control of every action the system takes, and when, without needing to learn code. The KrosFlo RS10 is part of the KrosFlo RS family, the most complete TFF platform on the market. Designed as a family, these systems are built to enable you to scale up or down or out efficiently and without major changes to your process. By having consistent process parameters and fluid dynamics throughout the entire family, meaning you can maintain the same TMP values, flux rates, fluid velocities, pump dynamics, and even the same software and recipes. So, to summarize, the new KrosFlo RS10 is the first fully automated bench scale CGMP system on the market, featuring end-to-end automation for all the processes beyond just UFDF. The ability to choose your ideal feed pump so you can tailor the system to your specific application's needs. Low holdup volumes enabled by the injection molded manifolds and valve blocks, which enable better recovery. Filter flexibility for use with hollow fiber or flat sheets, and our advanced analytical options, including the ability to upgrade to an RPM system with Flow VPX for real-time concentration control. All of these features come together to provide a CGMP bench scale TFF solution that's ideal for personalized medicine, therapeutics, and applications requiring really small batches. And with that, I'd like to thank you all for joining us for today's webinar. As I said, we are very excited to roll this system out. If you'd like more information on the system or have requests for literature, please contact your local Repligen representative directly. Otherwise, I look forward to answering any questions you may have during our Q&A portion.